What's up, guys? Welcome to another episode of Slam for Fun, and today we have one I'm actually very excited about. About a month or so ago, it's been now, Snyder's of Hanover came out with their own flavor of beer. If you guys don't know Snyder's of Hanover, they're pretzels, very good pretzels, and they came out with two flavors of their beer for Oktoberfest, which we didn't really have time to celebrate because our
work schedules
didn't work out, but I got them. They're nice and ice cold in the fridge. And what can you tell about them?
Well, this one says Snyder's beer.
What we got?
Pretzel.
Malt beverage with natural flavor. Bats brewed with Snyder's of Hanover mini pretzels. All right. Let's see what we got. Alcohol by volume. Oktoberfest, yeah, I don't know how we said that. Where is APV? You see that anywhere?
APV.
This one's 5. And that one.
This was 4.5.
Alright. Okay, now shall we try to put through the names.
Okay.
Pretzel. Marzen? Yeah. You guys can tell me more about this.
This one's called Pretzel.
Let's see, yeah. What do you got?
Pretzel Fooch?
Pretzel Fooch?
Pretzel Fooch.
Oh, we're probably butchering the names, but yeah. It's alright.
Yeah.
What one do you want to try first, huh?
Let's try mine first.
That New Year's?
Yeah.
Open it up, okay, the smell. Okay, before. Yeah. Very excited about this one. Oh, what do you smell like?
Huh, smells like a real beer.
Smells like beer? Smells like a beer?
Yeah.
Warm me up. Guys, we have done a pretzel beer before on the show. We did it a couple months back. And it was alright. I mean, didn't really taste much pretzel in it. It was just the beer.
Yeah.
The beer that tasted like a beer. Yeah. Alright.
Really?
Huh?
Yeah, it definitely looks like a beer.
Yeah. Any Oktoberfest chance that you know?
Not really.
Yeah, me either.
Yeah.
Oh, well, let's just give her a shot.
Yeah, here you go. Cheers.
Cheers, my friend.
Yeah. Really good.
Okay.
That's actually really good.
It's really sweet.
It is sweet.
That's a sweet beer.
I actually really like this one.
Yeah, I don't mind that at all.
That's actually really good. It has a little aftertaste, but not like, you know, it was bad or anything, but...
Yeah, no. Nothing bad about that one at all.
Yeah, actually, Tommy, I think it's one of the best beers you bought.
Yeah, it's good.
In my opinion, but, yeah. I actually really like this.
Yeah. Yeah, he's not a beer guy.
I'm not a beer guy, either.
Yeah. Huh. I'll be damned. That ain't bad.
This is actually really good.
Yeah, that's a more tasty beer.
Yeah. I could probably freaking chug a whole 4-pack of that.
Right?
Yeah, this is actually really good.
Yeah, this is really good.
Like, you could definitely taste. You could tell the hop. You could taste the hops and all that stuff in it.
Yeah.
But this is a delicious beer.
Yeah, I...
Yeah.
I like this one, actually. Brewed with passion fruit and guava. That's why it's so sweet.
What the hell is guava?
It's like, trying to think what... Trying to think what kind of fruit to pair it with. I know what it is, I just don't know how to describe it. It's a sweet fruit.
Okay. There you go, that's the way, okay.
I don't know how else to describe it. It's, I don't know. But, passion fruit. That's why it's so sweet.
This is a really good beer, though.
What's this one? Spontaneous? out and says Oktoberfest style beer.
Okay.
Yeah, didn't even catch that. Passion fruit. Nice. Alright. Now on to the other one. Not as strong as the smell as the other one.
To me, this really doesn't even have a smell.
Yeah, see, it doesn't.
Yeah.
Not a strong smell.
Yeah.
Alright. Nice pour.
Yeah.
A little darker.
Oh, yeah.
Looks a little bit like pee, but that's alright.
Yeah, it does look like, yeah, like a hard pee, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I'll have that. Alright. Alright, now I smell a little more. Don't think this one smells as good as the other one.
Yeah, same here.
This one smells a little... I don't know.
To me, I'm really not getting the smell on this, man.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hmm. This is like, it kind of looks like a dark Guinness.
I don't know about that. This is a little darker.
Well, I mean, it's damn close to it, man. I mean.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Huh. Well, you want me to try it?
Yeah, let's do it. To me, that one tastes like sweaty socks.
Yeah, that one's not as good.
Yeah. This is the winner.
Yeah, the red tan, yeah.
Yeah, I'll go back to this one.
Yeah. I mean, this one's not... I don't hate it, but... I mean, if I see it on the shelf, would I buy it again? Probably not.
No. Honestly, I would... I'm not a beer drinker, but I would buy this one.
Yeah, I'd buy that one again.
Yeah.
This one... Yeah, I can do without.
Yeah. That one's the winner. That one's awesome.
Yeah, that was good.
Yeah.
What was it going to be good for? A nice beer batter.
That would make a good beer batter, yeah.
Good beer batter? Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that's... Yeah, I haven't had beer batter fish in a long time, man.
Yeah, been a while.
I'll wait with you for the fish and chip.
Yeah.
Hey, who knows? Maybe if you guys want to, I'll do a video of cooking with this, and we'll make the fish and chips with Oktoberfest beer. That might be fun. A little something different.
Why not?
Yeah. Huh.
Well, it's good on getting colder outside.
Oh.
Yeah, that's what we think of that.
Yeah.
So, anywho.
Yeah, sir.
It's getting colder out. You guys going to be time soon to be doing one of my collection?
Yes, it is.
Yeah?
Yeah, it'll be.
It's...
Very soon.
Very soon. That's kind of overdue for it. Yeah. I've only been, what, almost 2 years since I've been mentioning it?
Yeah, about 2 years I've been talking about it and hyping it up, so...
So, it's kind of overdue.
Yeah.
We did one February of 2017. It was on Facebook Live.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, it pops up every now and then.
Every year in February, like middle of February, it always pops up. But in... How long ago was that? Is that 4 years?
Something like that, yeah.
In 4 year span, I've gotten a lot more than for the last 4 years.
And that's about like, what, almost 700 views? Maybe close to 8 now?
7, maybe 800. That actually got pretty good views, man.
Yeah, that did not bad for us.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, a lot of people I work with are wrestling fans, and they were showing to other people that are wrestling fans.
Yeah,
and,
yeah.
And in that 4 year span, I've gotten a lot more.
Yeah,
I have two rooms, I have entire attic floor from top to bottom.
Yeah.
I gotta clean out my attic so I can put more shelves in the back so I can get all the stuff on the floor.
Yeah, right.
I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do it with all the stuff on the floor so I can see how much I've been building up.
It's not a bad idea.
Then we could go back maybe like a month later and we could do...
So you're all shelved up.
All shelved up, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I like that idea.
Yeah. Yeah, so kind of overdue. I don't want to be long videos though.
Yeah,
we'll maybe 20 minutes on each.
Yeah, that sounds about good.
I'll just go over with everything real quick. You can see all the stuff. And
yeah.
Once you guys see it, you're going to be blown away.
It's very impressive.
It's something you guys don't see every day, pretty
much.
Oh, no.
No. That's not something the average person has in their house.
No, it's really not. Yeah. There's not too many people out there that they say they could have 3 rooms full of wrestling figures.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's,
Yeah.
It's pretty crazy, isn't it?
Yeah, right? And I'm not stopping anytime soon.
Oh, no, I know this.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't think I told you. I ordered 2 Detolfs.
Detolfs,
like the last Detolfs.
Oh, around, yeah.
So I could put some of my really expensive ones in.
Yeah, I know, I've been telling you for a while, but...
I got two Detolfs, yeah.
Yeah, protect those ones, man.
Yeah.
Some of those are worth a lot of cash, man.
I bought 2... I think they're like 5 feet, they're maybe like this big.
Oh, nice.
They're like literally this big.
Yeah.
And they have LED lights in them.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Where did you buy those at?
I ordered them online. I paid $120 a piece.
Amazon?
eBay.
Nice.
Yeah, eBay, yeah.
Very nice.
Yeah.
That's awesome, dude.
So, I get displaced in my really expensive ones.
Yeah.
Oh, I got really expensive ones. I spent a lot of money on these goddamn things. Yeah.
Yeah, he has.
I want to put all my Hasbros in there and...
Yeah, that is nice.
Yeah, get the dust off them. Like, some of the Hasbros, like, I spent, like... they're the only figures I actually like buying loose.
Yeah,
I like buying Hasbro's loose. And I'm not saying that because price-wise. I think the Hasbro's display better than the loose.
I don't know, it's fun to display.
I mean, on the card, they really don't stand up on the card. If you don't have the protector.
Yeah.
Because they make protectors for them now, for the Hasbro's.
Yeah, alright.
Yeah, but remember, the Hasbro's, all they did was they just come in, they were in a bubble.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
That's it. They want a bobble on a card. You can't stand them up.
Yeah, no, not really.
Yeah. They're the only figures I actually enjoy buying loose. I'm not saying because of the price-wise. I just really just buy them loose. As long as they're in good condition.
Yeah.
And they're not broken. They're not missing arms or fingers or heads or anything.
Can you choose it off?
Yeah, yeah, right? Yeah.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah. I have stuff that he never saw before.
Yeah.
I'm gonna put it there.
Oh, nice.
I have a.
Yeah, look forward to that.
I have a. Five prototypes that I bought over the years. That I have stashed away.
That's awesome.
They all came straight away. They were from Jax. And I have a lot of.
Can you eBay all them?
No.
No, really?
No, I bought them off reputable deals.
That's awesome.
They all came. They were all legit stuff. They were not.
They're not knockoffs.
They're all. One of them was like all. They're all like serial resin and stuff like that.
Alright.
Yeah.
Huh. That's pretty simple. I didn't know that.
Yeah, I have prototypes. I have
That's awesome.
What else? The one of the hundreds I have.
Yeah, I like those. Those are nice.
Yeah, about a month ago, I made a big boy AEW purchase. I bought the 1/500 Matt Hardy.
Did you really?
Yeah, I spent $600 on
that. Yeah, I didn't know about that.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, and then,
Wow.
Yeah, I never told him that one.
Yeah, no, that's news to me, guys.
And then about 2 months prior to that, I bought the 1/1000 Cody. In the gold.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I remember.
The gold tights.
Yeah.
I spent $430 on that.
Holy moly!
Huh? It's an addiction. If there was a wrestling figure we have, goddammit, I should be in there.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Some digital addiction. Oh, wow.
Oh, then the last one was, I bought it did a John Moxley variant with, he had an eye patch on.
Oh, I haven't seen
But that was the upper, that was like I think 1/5000 though. I spent $400 on that.
Oh, man.
Yeah, it's, I never told him that.
Yeah, no, these are all new to me, guys.
I have them in, like, Ringside Collectibles has these cases you can put them in. And I have them stashed in a room in my house. Yeah. Oh, and another one was, what was the other one I got? Oh, Britt Baker. Oh, yeah. I bought her variant. I think $350 on that.
Wow.
Yeah, it's...
Alright, yeah, don't feel so bad for spending money on stupid stuff I buy. Like, all that steals a soda.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I spend money on expensive plastic figures.
Yeah.
I'm not ashamed of it. I've been involved in wrestling figures since I was 4 years old.
Yeah.
My dad, do you remember those WCW ones, those really hard plastic ones?
Yes, I do.
94, when I was in preschool, my very first figure was a Hulk Hogan figure. I remember coming home that day from preschool, and he had the figure on the bed. I think it was for my birthday. Done. That's what started it all.
Yeah.
So from 1994, what was that, 27 years ago?
Yes.
Okay. So now, it's been nonstop.
Wow.
And then once I got older, and I got money, and I'm working my balls off, and I could afford these things.
Yeah.
It's an addiction. I'm not the only one that's addicted to this. There's tons of collectors out there that spend money on this stuff.
Yeah.
So, I'm not the only one.
Yeah. Hey, man.
Yeah. And,
That tasted bad.
I'm kind of... What was the other one? There's one more I bought, too. I'm trying to remember it. I mentioned Cody.
Alright.
Matt Hardy. Britt.
Hmm.
Moxley.
Yeah, I don't...
There was one more I got, too.
Yeah. Darby? Anything special with him?
There is variants on Dobby, but I don't have any of them.
Alright,
Oh, no, wait a minute. I found the chase. The Dobby chase at Target. A match chase.
Oh, right.
Yeah, I found that about I think that was about, like, 2 months ago I found it.
Oh, it's pretty recent, yeah.
Yeah.
Very nice.
And I didn't drop an obscene amount of money. I just walked in Target and it was on the shelf.
Yeah,
I paid retail for it.
Yeah, Target, yeah, that's not bad.
But, I did get that one. There was one more I spent an obscene amount of money on. MJF.
Ah.
Series 2 MJF. That one was a little cheaper. I only spent $250 on that one.
Ah, that's it?
Yeah. that was actually pennies.
Yeah.
But, yeah. So. Damn, this is a good beer, man.
Yeah, that one's good.
This one's delicious.
Ooh, very sweet, though. Not the bad way, though, but this...
Yeah.
Very sweet.
Yeah.
This one, not so much.
I know, right?
Kind of wish it tasted more like pretzel.
Yeah.
I've only ever had one pretzel beer that tasted like pretzel. I mean, that was only a one-and-done thing.
Oh, was it?
It was so good, too.
Yeah.
And man, did it give me the frippin' really bad dance. I remember I bought a 4-pack of it and I went to work the next day. Oh, I was dropping bombs on everybody.
Yeah.
It was awesome.
Yeah.
Let's see, what else we got here?
What else? Oh, I do have a Jericho chase that I bought off Ringside.
Oh, yeah?
I only spent $100 on it.
Oh, that's not too bad.
That was some Series 1. Oh, yeah. I have that stashed away. I've had that for a while now.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Like, I have the majority of the chases. I just keep them stashed. I keep them in protectors and stashed away.
Yeah, that's
good. Yeah. But then I get the Detolf set up. They're going in the Detolfs.
Yeah.
I'd rather put them in the Detolfs than have them in a box and...
Yeah.
In summer, yeah.
Yeah, I'm glad you finally broke down the doctors.
Yeah.
That's a little overdue.
Yeah. I got them the other day. I didn't didn't get a chance to put them together yet, but
all right.
I gotta set up room and all that stuff and fill the back of my attic because I got so much freaking boxes back there. It's not even funny. In my freaking attic, if you knock one of the figures over, it was like freaking dominoes. It's like going in my attic is like walking on freaking eggshells.
Yeah, you gotta be careful.
Yeah.
You can't be going up there holding up the old suitcases.
Yeah, no, you can't. Yeah. And what else? I'm trying to think what else I have that. Oh god, I got so much. I actually have stuff stashed away that he never saw before.
Yeah, I'm excited to see that.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Let's see where we got time here. Let's see where we're at. Just going over, so we're probably out a little over. I have to put it home soon.
How much, man?
It carried over, so I guess it's all over, at least over 20. So
okay.
Let's bring this one home.
All right, you guys.
All right, guys. Well, this one went a little long-winded, but that's okay. We had ourselves a couple pints, and
yeah.
We'll see you on the next one.
See you guys. Take it easy.